Well, first of all, Ruti and Rakeli, the two primary dancers who are here, when I went to the house and went up to the second floor and sat on the couch, and they did a two and a half minute dance for me, which is actually in the show. It's a duet closest to the frame. My heart stopped. It was just one of the most beautiful things I had ever seen. These two bodies that had been dancing together for over 40 years, performing something so minimal to a metronome, it immediately made me stop in my tracks. I thought I'd maybe make one photograph in Israel. I wasn't planning to do a big project. I had just finished lunch break. I was like, gonna take a break. And then Noah also made hundreds and hundreds of these wall carpets. And I had been interested in textiles for like 20 years, always collecting them, researching them, going into archives at museums, but nothing ever grabbed me. And when I saw Noah's carpets, I was immediately inspired, because she had this other kind of system that she used for making the carpets, which was seems so different from the notation system, because they're very colorful. No one's seen the show yet, so. But they're all scrap fabrics from the garment district in Tel Aviv that she and her friends and dancers would collect. And Noah would never cut the fabric. So there was this kind of structuralist approach to the carpets. They're incredible. They're, some are homages to artists. Some are direct responses to wars that are happening. She started making the carpets during the Yom Kippur War when Shmulek, one of her primary dancers at the time, left the house. A lot of them are sewn on backs of army blankets. It has this historical, I mean, this is the next book, I think, about Noah, is when you show the carpets in Israel, there's a reading of every fabric. It's, you know, people who came to the exhibition would say, oh, that's the pattern of my grandmother wore that skirt, and that's the kibbutz curtains that were, you know, so it had this other kind of history. So, yeah, I'm just like running on and on, like, oh,
did I answer your question?
So, as soon as they did the dance for me, I knew I had to come back, and then I just kept coming back and back and back, and the project just kept getting bigger and bigger. And this is a real huge step for me as an artist, because I've never done a multiple channel installation, and I always work with sound, and I work with a composer, but this was so interesting to work with something of such simplicity, 120 beats per minute of a metronome, and making a composition that consists of five parts in unison. So, yeah, so it was really exciting, and I wanted to challenge this idea of authorship, and, you know, and I mean, since lunch break, I've been bringing in others' work into my exhibitions, and it's just been building and building. It's just more exciting for me to always, like, have some kind of a challenge and to blur the lines of whose art is whose. Am I interpreting Noah's work? Is this Noah's work? You know, we're given equal space. The book is, the texts are dedicated to both of our practices, and then our practices together. I mean, there's definitely an overlap of my interests and hers, for sure, I think.